Well, it's a fresh start for Dan Campbell and the Miami Dolphins. Good morning, everyone. I'm Michael Coliani. Well, after starting the season out 1-3, the Fins dumped head coach Joe Philbin in favor of fiery tight ends coach Dan Campbell. So would he be able to fire up the team yesterday as they headed to Nissan Stadium to take on the Titans? Well, you're about to find out. Here's a look at Campbell, calm, cool, and collected in his first game as an NFL head coach. Things would start out fantastically for Miami. Check this out with the trickery. They execute the misdirection with Jarvis Landry. He's going to take it in from 22 yards out to score and give the Dolphins the early lead, just brushing off defenders left and right. That was Landry's first career rushing touchdown. Now 24-10, 10 minutes left in the fourth. Beautiful play there by Brent Grimes to snag the interception from rookie Marcus Mariota. Dude's got some serious ball skills. Fins win 38-10. Congratulations, Dan Campbell. And now to Sunday Night Football, which many of you witnessed last night right here on NBC. Tom Brady and company taking on Andrew Luck in the Colts. Second quarter here, Brady's pass to Julian Edelman goes off the receiver's hands, and Mike Adams turns it the other way for a pick six. Adams actually has three picks off Brady in his career, most of any active player. And then look at this bizarre sequence by the Colts. It's fourth down, third quarter. They're the most confused people out there, the Colts players. They don't know what to do. Botch, snap, they turn it over. Patriots are going to take advantage almost right away. Nothing that the Colts players could do with that one. Brady, that's all he needs, one mistake, and he is going to get away from some pressure here. Draw the D in, hit LeGarrette Blount in the flat. Boom, 6 points right there. Pats win 34-27. So unlucky or injury prone? That's the question that is undoubtedly on the minds of a lot of Buffalo Bills fans when it comes to South Fort Myers legend Sammy Watkins. And after telling the Buffalo News earlier this week that he deserves at least 10 targets a game, the Bills were looking to get the talented wideout more involved yesterday, but that wouldn't work out so well for Sammy or the team. While breaking free for a beautiful touchdown grab in the second quarter yesterday against the Bengals, Watkins appears to slip while trying to plant his left leg and ankle. He would make the catch for seven, but almost immediately fall to the turf, grabbing his left ankle in obvious pain. Now, the good news for Bills fans is that the x-rays were negative, so no break, but a pretty bad sprain. Watkins was seen limping heavily on one crutch in the Bills locker room after the game, refusing interviews. By the way, my Bills lost 34-21. And now to Kansas Speedway for the Hollywood Casino 400 yesterday. Second race of the contender round of NASCAR's Chase for the Sprint Cup Series. Five laps to go. Matt Kenseth tries to block Joey Logano because he's got the lead, but he spins out of control. He's able to save himself from hitting the wall. But that would be it for Logano. He crosses the checkered marker first. That is a win for Joey Logano, his second in a row. And Kenseth, not a happy camper after that finish. In the
second round. I won't talk to Joey. I don't have anything to talk to him about, really. So, I mean, you make decisions every day. You make decisions every minute behind a wheel. I'm one of the only guys, I think, that haven't been into it yet with Joey. And I've always raced him with a ton of respect. I've actually been one of his biggest fans. I'm certainly not anymore, but I always was.
Kenseth throwing some serious shade at the young Joey Logano there. Well, that's going to do it for this morning edition of NBC2 Sports. Thanks for watching. I'm Mike Coliani.